Yes. See, in the last class, we discussed two problems on redemption of preference shares. And today, we will see some advanced problems on redemption. Two more problems we will discuss today. So, problem number 10. Problem number 10 we are going to see now. One. See this question. The balance sheet of Nitin Spinner Limited as on 31st 3 2015 was as under. So liability side, share capital 15,005% redeemable preference shares of 10 each mentioned, that is 1,50,000. Then 30,000 equity shares of 10 each, that is 3 lakh. General reserve is mentioned, that is 1,60,000. Profit and loss account 55,000. Then security premium account is 1,35,000. Creditors 2 lakh. So liability side, all the information is mentioned. But if you see the question properly, here general reserve as well as profit and loss account information both are mentioned in the problem. When both the information is mentioned in the problem, which one we can use first? Whether general reserve or profit and loss account, which one we can use first? Anyone? Which one we can use first? If both balance is given in the liability side of the balance sheet in the question, which one we can use? General reserve or profit and loss account? Oh, which one we can use? Anyone? Unmute yourself or comment in the chat box. So we can use general reserve first. We can use general reserve first if both balance is mentioned in the question. So general reserve we can utilize. Then security premium account information is also mentioned. Asset side, plant and machinery, furniture, vehicle, investment, stock, debtors and bank balance is given. So total of the balance sheet is 10 lakh. Total of the balance sheet is 10 lakh. So let us see the adjustment. Let us see the adjustment now. So on 31/3/2015, company decided to redeem the preference shares at 5%. So here redemption of preference shares is done at a premium of 5%. For this purpose, it decided to sell the investment, which realized 97,500. So first thing you need to see, what is the investment amount given in the question? Investment amount given in the question is 1 lakh. So now it is realized for 97,500. So whether it is a profit or loss, original amount is 1 lakh. Now it is realized for 97,500. Whether it is a profit or loss? Anyone? Yes, it is a loss. It is a loss. So whenever there is a loss, what happens? Profit and loss account is debited in journal entry because of the loss. So how to calculate the loss? So 1 lakh minus 97,500. If you do, you can calculate the loss. That is 2,500. Give the journal entries and redraft the balance sheet. So very simple problem we will discuss now. So first thing we need to do is working note here. Preference share capital 1,50,000. So how to get 1,50,000? Directly given in the question. Redeemable preference shares of 10 each. So 15,000 into 10, that is 1,50,000. We got preference share capital. So now which balance we can utilize here? General reserve balance is given. Profit and loss account balance is given. However, profit and loss account balance is less than 1,50,000. And general reserve balance is more than 1,50,000. But if there is two balances given, we can use general reserve first. So we will utilize general reserve for the purpose of paying preference share capital. General reserve 1,50,000. Out of 1,60,000, we have taken now 1,50,000. So preference share capital is met by utilizing general reserve balance. Next, what about redemption premium? Premium they have set at 5%. So if you take 1,50,000 into 5%, you will get one amount, that is 7,500. So 7,500 either out of security premium or out of profit. So in this question, security premium account is mentioned in the question itself, that is 1,35,000. So there is a sufficient amount available. So security premium account, we can take it from 1,35,000, sufficient amount available, 7,500. So redemption premium is met by utilizing security premium account. So now we have done with two working mode. See this, this is very important now. Preference share capital can be redeemed out of divisible profits. Yes, but when there are both profit and loss and general reserve balance is given, it may be better to use general reserve first. So that is what we have done here. General reserve, we have used it first. So in the books of Nitin Spinner Limited, we need to pass the journal entry. After this, we need to pass the journal entry in the books of Nitin Spinner Limited. So let us see the journal entries one by one, whether there is a partly paid share. In this question, there is no partly paid share, but there is investment. So there is an investment adjustment is there. What is that investment adjustment? Sold the investment for 97,500. Before the original value is 1 lakh. So there is a loss. So journal entry will be bank account debit. So cash, when the investment is sold, cash comes in. What is the amount? Bank account debit, that is 97,500. Cash comes in. 97,500 profit and loss account debited. Why? Because there is a loss. 1 lakh minus 97,500, you will get 2,500 loss to investment account. That is, investment is realized. So that is 1 lakh. Total is 1 lakh being sale of investment. That is first journal entry you need to pass. Then after that, determining the amount due on redemption. How to determine the amount due on redemption? Directly from the working note, preference share capital plus premium. Capital plus premium is given to the preference share holder. So 5% preference share capital account debit, that is 15,000 into 10, 1,50,000. Then redemption premium account debit, that is 1,50,000. That is nothing but 15,000 into 10 into 5%. You will get 7,500 to preference shareholder. This is the amount due which is to be given to preference shareholder. That is 1,57,500 being the amount due on redemption. So now we know the amount due on redemption. After that, we need to see amount paid to preference shareholder. So when the amount paid to preference shareholder, what is the journal entry? Preference shareholder account debit to bank account being the payment made on redemption. So that is previous journal entry total, 1,57,500 is the payment made on redemption. Then fourth one, meeting the redemption premium. If you see the working note, redemption premium is met by utilizing security premium account. So very easy, you can pass the journal entry, that is security premium account debit to redemption premium account. Security premium to redemption premium account, amount is 7,500. Being redemption premium met, that is fourth journal entry. Fifth one, any profit if any for the purpose of redemption of capital can be transferred to capital redemption reserve account. So here we have utilized full balance of general reserve, that is working note one. So general reserve account debit to capital redemption reserve account, 1,50,000 being the redemption of capital out of general reserve. So there is no information about bonus shares, so no journal entry for that. So only five basic journal entry you need to pass in this problem. After that, you need to do revised balance sheet. So what and all information comes for revised balance sheet now? Share capital. So 30,000 equity shares of 10 they have mentioned. Whether this information is given in the question? 30, yes, see this. In the question itself, it is given 30,000 equity shares of 10. So directly from the question, we are going to write in the liability side share capital, that is 3 lakh. General reserve, original balance is 1,60,000, but we have utilized 1,50,000 for capital purpose, redemption of capital purpose. So what is the remaining balance? That is 10,000. Profit and loss account, again same thing. Profit and loss account balance given in the question. Once you see the question, profit and loss account balance given in the question is 55,000. But there is a loss. There is a loss because of sale of investment. Because it is sold at a lesser value. So what happens? That amount need to be deducted from profit and loss account credit balance. So 55,000 minus loss 2,500. You will get 52,500. Then capital redemption reserve, if it is not utilized, to be shown in the liability side of balance sheet. Journal entry number 5. General reserve account debit to capital redemption reserve 1,50,000 not utilized. So liability side CRR account 1,50,000. Then security premium account. Security premium account information given in the question, that is in the balance sheet itself, security premium account is given, that is 1,35,000. But 7,500 is met for meeting the redemption premium. So that you need to deduct from security premium account. Remaining balance is 1,27,500. So what about creditor? Creditor is 2 lakh. So whether creditor information is given in the question, yes, it is mentioned, that is 2 lakh. Then what about other assets? Plant, machinery, furniture, vehicle, stock, data, everything as it is. Then what about investment? Investment, why it doesn't appear? Because it is sold. So investment is not there. Remaining assets as it is. Plant and machinery 4 lakh, furniture 42,000, vehicle 48,000, stock 2,10,000, debtors 1,10,000. So these are directly from the balance sheet, but there is an adjustment for bank account. So what is the adjustment for bank account? First is 90,000 given balance. Balance is given 90,000 plus when the investments are sold, cash comes in. So 97,500 realized amount you need to add to bank account. 90,000 plus 97,500 minus payment made to preference shareholder. So see the journal entry number 3. You have made the payment using the bank account. So that amount you need to deduct from bank minus 1,57,500. Payment to preference shareholder, that is 30,000. So total of the balance sheet, both the side, that is 8,40,000. So this is how you are going to solve this problem. Very simple problem with less adjustment. Only investment adjustment is there. So whether there is any doubt in this problem now, any doubt in this problem, please ask if there is any doubt in this problem. Very simple problem. Please comment in the chat box if there is any doubt. No doubt. Others, whether there is doubt, no. Yes.
So for revised balance sheet.
Yeah.
Which year should we write, 2015 or 2016?
Revised balance sheet. Yeah. Revised balance sheet, we need to write 31-3. Because after the redemption of preference share, means redemption is done on 31-3, right? So revised balance sheet is also of 31-3 itself, 2015.
Which year?
2015.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, 2015 question is given. At the end of that year, balance sheet is, because redemption is done at the end of the financial year. So that year information you need to write. 2014-15 means 15 you need to write. Yes. Any other doubts regarding this question? Any other doubt regarding this question? No doubts. So we will see one more problem. We'll see one more last problem of this class. So next one. Next problem is problem number 11. Problem number 11 is of Anjali Limited. The balance sheet of Anjali Limited as on 31st March 2015 was as follow. So now liability side, 6,500 12% redeemable preference shares of 10 each mentioned. That is 65,000. Yes, given. Then 4,500 equity shares of 50 each, that is also mentioned. So there are preference share as well as equity share, 2,25,000. Then profit and loss account information is given, 48,000. Creditor 56,500. Asset side, fixed asset 3,45,000. Investment 18,500. Bank 31,000. Total of the balance sheet is 3,94,500. Now there are certain adjustments. In order to redeem the preference share, add 10% premium. So here preference shares are redeemed at premium. Company decided. So there are three conditions they have mentioned for the redemption of preference share. Now three conditions you need to satisfy. What are those conditions? First one, to sell the investment for 16,000. So you need to see the investment amount. First investment amount you need to see, that is 18,500 is your investment. So sold for 16,000 means again there is a loss. 18,500 is the original value. Now you are selling at a lesser amount, 16,000. So there is a loss. What is the loss amount? 18,500 minus 16,000. You will get loss, 2,500. Then to leave a balance of 12,000 in profit and loss account. So what do you mean by to leave a balance? So to leave a balance in P&L account means what is that? Anyone can tell me now? Can you tell me? To leave a balance of 12,000 in P&L account means what? You cannot utilize 12,000
of like the
tell. Yes. So you cannot utilize 12,000 from P&L account. That means what? That 12,000 need to be shown in the liability side of the balance sheet. So 12,000 you need to show in the liability side of the balance sheet. Then remaining you can utilize. Then third one, to issue sufficient number of equity shares of 50 each at a premium of 13 per share to raise the balance of fund required for redemption. That means what? After utilizing all the balance, after utilizing the balance of general reserve and profit and loss account, if necessary, provision of fresh issue is there. So what happens here? You need to calculate first balance available in profit and loss account. First thing you need to calculate. Then second thing you need to see is number of shares you need to see. Yes. Then equity shares were fully subscribed, pass journal entry and redraft the balance sheet. So now first thing you need to do is preference share capital. So before going for preference share capital, once we'll see this, preference share capital is 65,000. Whether it is given in the question, yes, 65,000 is mentioned. So we know now preference share capital is 65,000. But we don't know the balance available in profit and loss account. Why? Why we don't know the balance? Balance is given 48,000. But there are adjustments. What and all adjustment we have in profit and loss account? Can anyone tell me now? What and all adjustment we have in profit and loss account? 12,000 we cannot use. And one more thing is there. What is that? What is the one more adjustment is there in profit and loss account? Can anyone tell me now? Unmute yourself and tell me or mention in the chat box. What is that? One is 12,000 we cannot use. And one more adjustment is there in P&L account. So that adjustment is of investment we have sold, right? So investment we have sold, 18,500 worth investment is sold for 16,000. So there is a loss. Whenever there is a loss, that loss amount also you need to deduct. So first thing, before doing the working note, you need to find out the balance available in P&L account. So how to find out the balance available in P&L account? So see this. The working note, profit and loss account balance given in the question is 48,000. So now we know 48,000 is profit and loss account balance less loss on sale of investment. So loss we need to deduct from P&L balance, because P&L credit balance is mentioned, loss is a debit balance. So 18,000 minus 16,500, you will get 2,500 that you need to deduct from 48,000. Again minus amount to be retained also you need to deduct, that is 12,000, that also you need to deduct from the 48,000. So total deduction from 48,000 is 14,500, that is 2,500 plus 12,000. So now amount available in profit and loss account for the purpose of redemption is 33,500. So this is very important now. 33,500 is amount we have for the purpose of redemption. So now you go for working note. Preference share capital 65,000, we will take 33,500, that is full amount from profit and loss account. So we have taken full amount from profit and loss account. What about remaining amount? 65,000 minus 33,500, if you do, remaining amount is 31,500. For 31,500, there is adjustment. What is that? To issue sufficient number if required. So there is a sufficient number of fresh issue of equity shares are now issued. Fresh issue of equity share, remaining amount 31,500. Next thing, redemption premium. Next working note is redemption premium. See the premium. Premium is 10%. So on 65,000, if you take 10%, you will get 6,500. on the capital you need to take 10%, you will get 6500. So for this purpose you need to utilize which balance? Profit and loss balance or security premium balance? So here profit and loss balance you cannot utilize, because it is again there are also restriction, and we have utilized for capital redemption. For premium redemption, now we need to see only security premium balance. Security premium balance how to see? So that for that reason you need to do this working note. So what is this working note? Calculation of balance available in security premium account. How to find out the balance available in security premium account? Once you see the fresh issue information. See this fresh issue information, they have said 50 each at a premium of 13. So now we know the premium of 13 per share. For fresh issue, 13 per share is a premium we know, but number of shares we don't know. So how to calculate number of shares? So for that you need to do working note, that is value of equity share. After P&L balance, after you determine the P&L balance, below that you can show value of equity share. So how to get the value of equity share? Value of equity shares to be issued is preference share capital is 65,000 minus P&L account. Minus P&L account, that is 33,500 we have utilized for the purpose of redemption. Now remaining balance in preference share capital is 31,500. So now 31,500 we need to take it from fresh issue. So now we know 31,500 we need to take it from fresh issue. So how to determine number of equity share? 31,500 divided by 50. From where we got 50? See this 50 each. So now we know the face value that is given in the question, 50 each. So 31,500 divided by 50, if you do, you will get 630 shares. So now we know number of equity shares, that is 630 shares. By using this information, we can easily find out balance available in security premium account. So 630 is a number of equity shares issued at premium, that is 13 given in the question. 630 into 13, that is 8190 is the balance available in security premium. So now 8190, there is sufficient balance. We want only 6500. So 6500 is taken from security premium account as there is sufficient balance. So this is about the working note, preference share capital, redemption premium, balance available in profit and loss account, number of shares available, all working note we need to do before passing the journal entry. After that, in the books of Anjali Limited, journal entries. So now journal entry, first thing we need to see is investment, about investment. See, the investment amount is 18,500 is the investment amount, then it is sold for 16,000. So whenever the investment is sold, what is the journal entry now? What is the journal entry? Can you tell the journal entry? When investment is sold and when there is a loss, what is the journal entry? Can you tell the normal case? Loss or profit you leave, can you tell the normal case when the investment is sold, what is the journal entry? Anyone, unmute yourself.
Bank account data, profit and loss account data to investment.
Yes, that is in the case of, that is in the case of loss. Yes, correct. That is in the case of loss. And what is the normal journal entry? Bank to investment. Bank to investment is a normal journal entry. When there is a loss, P&L you need to debit. When there is a profit, P&L you need to credit. But in this question, there is a loss. So, see this now, whatever you told is correct now. Bank account debit 16,000, profit and loss account debit 2,500, because that is a loss, to investment account. To investment account is 18,500, being the sale of investment. Being the sale of investment. So, second one, fresh issue. Second thing is for fresh issue. So, fresh issue, here we know fresh issues are done, that is 31,500. So, what is the journal entry for fresh issue now? Journal entry for fresh issue. Anyone? Unmute yourself. Fresh issue journal entry. Anyone? What is the fresh issue journal entry? Can you tell me the fresh issue journal entry now? Very easy. What is that? Bank account debit. Bank account debit to. Bank account debit to equity share capital account. Bank account debit to equity share capital account. Yes. So So we'll see that yes, second journal entry, bank account debit to equity share capital account 630. We know the number of share we have calculated 630. 630 into 50 we will get 31,500. But there is a premium amount is also given in the question. See that premium amount 13 per share given in the question. So two security premium, because security premium has credit balance. So two security premium, that is bank account debit to equity share capital, two security premium, that is 630 into 13, that is 8190, being fresh issue of equity share. After that, amount due on redemption. How to calculate amount due on redemption? Very easy. Capital plus premium. Directly from the working note. So 12% preference share capital account debit, that is 6,500 into 10, 65,000. And redemption premium account debit, that is nothing but 65,000 into 10%, that is 6,500. Directly from the working note. If you see the working note, you will get, see this 65,000 and 6,500. So total amount due on redemption is 71,500. 71,500 is total amount due on redemption. Now this amount is given to preference shareholders. So preference shareholders account debit to bank account, that is 71,500, being payment made on redemption. So now actual amount is given to preference shareholder. After that, meeting the redemption premium. So now in this question, how we met the redemption premium? Using security premium. So security premium account debit to redemption premium. So we have utilized the balance of security premium. So security premium account debit to redemption premium, that is 6,500. 6,500 we have written, being redemption premium met. Next journal entry, amount equal to the nominal value must be transferred to CRR. That is only out of profits other than the fresh issue. So once you see the working note, other than the fresh issue means other than 31,500, whatever else, all remaining information of capital you need to transfer to CRR. Only one information, profit and loss account. So profit and loss account debit to capital redemption reserve account 33,500. So being redemption of capital out of profit. So this journal entry, now we transferred P&L to capital redemption reserve for the purpose of issuing bonus share. So you need to pass 6 journal entries. In this question, only 6 journal entries you need to pass. After that, redrafted balance sheet. So balance sheet, if you see liability side, share capital 5130. So how we got 5130? That is 5130 of 50 each. First 4500 is given in the question and 630 is a fresh issue. We have calculated, right? Number of equity shares available, that is fresh issue, working note 630. So total is 5130 equity shares of 50 each, 256,500, that is share capital. Capital redemption reserve, that is journal entry number 6. No, we have not utilized CRR amount, so liability side. Capital redemption reserve 33,500. Then profit and loss account 12,000. Now this is from the adjustment, 12,000. They said 12,000 you need to leave in profit and loss account. So 12,000, that 12,000 you need to show in the liability side. Then the security premium account, we have calculated the balance available in security premium account. How we calculated the balance available in security premium account? See this, 630, number of fresh issue into premium, 8190. 8110 is a balance available. We utilize 6,500. So difference amount goes to balance sheet. What is the difference amount? 8190 minus 6500, you will get 1690. Then creditor is 56,500, that is given in the question itself. Then asset side, if you see fixed asset, that is given in the question, 3,45,000. Now bank, there are various adjustments. See this bank information given in the asset side bank information in the question is 31,000. So 31,000 plus sold. Whenever investment is sold, realized amount. Add that realized amount, investment sold 16,000 plus 36,690 from where we got fresh issue. That is capital plus premium of fresh issue. Journal entry number 2. That is journal entry number 2. 39,690. 31,500 plus 8190, 39,690. So this is not 36,000, 39,690. Correction, 39,690. Fresh issue you need to add. After that, After that, you need to deduct payment 71,500. Journal entry number 4. See that preference share to bank. So from bank we are paying the amount to holders, preference shareholder. So deduct 71,500. So that is payment. So total remaining balance in bank after all adjustment is 15,190. 15,190 is a balance. So total of the both the side, liability as well as asset side, is 360,190. 360,190. That is total of the both the side. Yes. So 6 journal entry and 1 balance sheet you need to pass. So whether there is any doubt in this question, if there is any doubt, you can ask in this question now. Yes, unmute yourself. Unmute yourself. Whether there is a doubt in this question. Yes, comment in the chat box. If there is any doubt, now you can ask.